r/AskReddit 911 dispatchers, what's the dumbest call you've ever received? A friend of mine once called 911 when he was a kid, because his aunt was having a baby at the hospital. Had a drunk person call to report he was being harassed. Truth was, he was being arrested by our officers for throwing pizza at people. All I heard in the background was one of my officers saying to him that better not be our dispatcher on the phone, followed by some muffled talking, and my officer taking the phone and saying he will be taking a ride with us now and hung up. Still laugh about it to this day. Also had a drunk woman call 911 because she couldn't remember her phone passcode. Caller, a deer just swam across the river behind my house. Me, okay. Caller, well I'm worried it might be cold. Me, well there is nothing we can do about a deer being cold. Didn't it run off after swimming the river? Caller, yes. Me, well ma'am it's a wild animal and I'd guess it's going to be fine. Caller, okay. I have been in the 911 biz for over 22 years. If a caller starts the call with "I swear I'm not crazy," then you need to buckle up for some insanity. A guy started a call with those words after escaping from his apartment and running to the closest 7-Eleven. He swore that his roommates were turning into giant crabs. The was going to show the officers that they were currently in giant cocoons transforming. As you might expect, he was tripping balls. My mom works as a 911 operator. She got a call one time from a girl in gym class at the local high school. She was in a panic and completely serious, saying there was a squirrel on top of a telephone pole at the school and it wasn't coming down. Not an operator, but my boyfriend who called in. He usually worked a late shift, walking home about 2 a.m. This shift he got off work a few hours late. BF, I'd like to call and report a fire. We live in a fire-prone area, and it was the season. 911, where is it located, sir? BF, on the hillside just east of city. 911, can you be more specific? Typing away in the background. BF, yes, gives a more detailed location. Oh god, it's getting bigger. The whole top of the hill is on fire now. 911, stay calm, sir, we are sending somebody out. BF, it's getting bigger. Doesn't anybody else see this? It's lighting up the sky around it. It's huge. Oh god. Oh, wait. 911, sir? BF, I'm so sorry. I'm not usually out this time of night. I just got off work late. That's the sun. 911. BF, I'm so sorry for wasting your time. There is no fire. That's just the sun rising. Never mind. I'm really embarrassed. 911, that's fine, sir. I will cancel the call. Thank you for calling. How far down is it snowing? All the way to the ground. Now get the off my emergency line. The neighbor is giving my horse drugs. 0500 or earlier, every single day. Usually followed up about an hour later by "it's crack." Lady, nobody is giving your horse drugs. Drugs are expensive. And my personal favorite, exact quote, my washing machine is telling me to file for bankruptcy. This was a confused elderly lady, so it was actually a little sad, but I'm including it because it left me completely speechless at the time. I think my response was, "I, you, what?" Was a 911 operator at my previous job. Had a woman call 911 because she saw someone driving down the road with his foot out the window. She was following him the whole time and admitted he had his seatbelt on, wasn't texting or speeding, he just had his foot out the window. She wanted the police to pull him over, to which I had to explain he wasn't breaking any laws. She couldn't comprehend that driving with your foot out the window is not illegal and proceeded to hang up on me, then call 911 again because apparently I didn't know the law and she needed someone to stop this man. We connected her to a deputy, who told her if she didn't stop calling 911 for stupid reasons, he was going to ticket her for abuse of emergency communications. Oh dear god, time to shine. Had a lady trying to call an ambulance because she opened a package from Amazon at home and she was afraid that her kid was about to have a major allergic reaction from the packing peanuts, because the kid was allergic to peanuts, and when her kid mentioned what they were called, she freaked out. not an operator, I'm a prosecutor. Guy lived in a rooming house that had a public area where all the residents could hang out. It had a microwave in it, provided by the landlord. Guy called 911 around midnight one night because the microwave wasn't there. The conversation with the dispatcher went something like this. Dispatcher, so, you called 911 because a microwave you don't even own is missing? Did you ask your landlord if he took it? Guy, no. Dispatcher, well, that's not an emergency, sir. Guy, but I'm really hungry. Meanwhile, a person with an actual emergency had to be put on hold briefly because this guy was adamant that this was the worst thing to ever happen. The genius insisted that police officers be sent to his rooming house as soon as possible because of the missing microwave. Officers showed up so they could cite him for improper use of 911. The guy pleaded not guilty and requested a jury trial. He represented himself. The jury was out 20 minutes before it announced its guilty verdict. Me, 911, this line is recorded. What is your emergency? Caller, hi, I don't know if this counts, but 4 days ago I noticed a U-Haul truck in my neighbor's driveway. Me, okay. Caller, well, the two guys looked really suspicious. They were walking around the house like they didn't belong there. Me, 4 days ago. Caller, it's been bothering me because my neighbors have been on vacation and no one should be there. Me, okay, we'll take a look. The entire house had been ransacked. All the valuables were gone. Too much time had passed for the local pawn shops to have the items because they know what is stolen and needs to be moved quickly. LPT, if something doesn't seem right, don't ever second guess calling the cops immediately. If the operator gives you attitude, make a complaint. X911 operator. Worked in the Midwest. Lots of your garden variety daily dumb calls, but this is next level stupid. Story goes a little something like this. 911. What is the location of your emergency? UHH. Address. Sigh. So, I'm not really sure if this is an emergency. Ugh, this is so embarrassing. I'm sorry. I answered an ad on Craigslist for some services, you know, with a woman. And somehow this ends in you dialing 911 at 1 a.m. And I answered the ad that said, back quote, send me what you got. So I sent her, sigh, you know, some pictures. I got a reply that, oh my god, that said I had sent these photos to his daughter who was 16. I didn't know. I really didn't know. I think maybe someone put her number there as a joke, you know? Right, okay. So you want to speak with an officer? What's your name? Well, I don't. I don't wanna say my name and get in trouble or anything. I'm just worried that this needs to be brought to someone's attention and get it out there, you know? You're on a recorded line with all of your information on our computer, homie, but proceed. I transfer the call to the on-duty sergeant, hoping he'll open up to another dude. He does. And then the truth erupts into a twisted tale of a love trapezoid straight out of an M. Night Shyamalan diary. It turns out the caller wasn't a child predator at all. He was just a horny kid on the prowl for some very legal kitty. A particular ad from a woman in a city called Hooker, you not, claiming to be 25 years old piqued, among other things, his interest, and he dutifully complied to the demand for shots. A brief time later he was textually accosted by a reasonably enraged man claiming to be the father of the alleged juvenile. Homeboy apologizes profusely and attempts to explain the situation by sending daddy a link to the ad in question. Presumably followed by the ordering of P90X and gathering of bail money. It is at this point the story takes a nosedive. Daddy, well, isn't. Dad's true identity becomes hubby. His innocent little girl's phone is actually the phone of his wife. I believe it. Most 16-year-olds haven't been dissatisfied long enough to turn to a Craigslist ad for W4mm. That's woman for multiple men. BTW. Police 911 operator here for 15 years. The stories I have. I've had someone call 911 to know how long to smoke a brisket. I've had someone call 911 to ask what the fines for parking tickets are. I've had someone call 911 to wish me a Merry Christmas. When I was working at 3 a.m. on Christmas morning, I've had someone call 911 report that their trunk wasn't opening and they wanted to know what to do about it. I've had someone call 911 in a rural community because a black dude was walking down the street and we don't get their kind here. I worked on 9 over 11. I had people call 911 4 weeks after because there were 3 brown guys in a car and I thought you should know about it. I've had someone call 911 because they were lonely about 1000 times and many many more. I've done this for a while. Do people abuse the system? Sure. But for the most part I'm happy with how our children are taught to only use 911 if it's a life or death emergency or if there's a crime in progress. My mom is a 911 operator. She gets some insanely stupid calls. I remember a few years ago, there was a huge pileup involving several cars and fatalities. Clearly it caused miles of traffic. A woman called 911, insisting that she get escorted out of the traffic by a trooper because she had to get home. And it was ridiculous that she should be stuck like that. Like, people are dead, lady. Sorry, you're not gonna make it home for Jeopardy. And before anybody asks, no, she had no medical condition, unless you count delusions of grandeur.